The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by EduPal, home of the $5 course. Check out my Excel class, Excel Formulas, the Dirty Dozen, at tinyurl.com/EduPal5. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1925. Explain the VLOOKUP true binary search method, also known as, why is my VLOOKUP giving me the wrong answer when I break the rules? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in on a discussion on Google Plus. Rahim is saying, oh, hey, why is the VLOOKUP true giving me the wrong answer? And I explained that if you're doing a VLOOKUP true with unsorted data, you're not going to get the correct result. Well, you might get the correct result, but if you do, it was just dumb luck. And Rahim comes back and says, no, can you explain this to me? And I'm sorry, I hate to discuss VLOOKUP true because no one uses VLOOKUP true. I mean, remember my Twitter poll here. Almost everyone says 99.999% false. Lewis was the only guy who answered the Twitter poll that actually had a reason. Uses approximate match to create reference tables instead of nested if statements, and that's a great use for VLOOKUP true. But the simple fact is, no one that I've run into in the real world is using these. It's always the false version. The only time I'm using true is when I'm in a class and I have to explain what it is for, or when I'm answering this type of question, why is the true giving me the wrong answer when I'm breaking the rules? Here's the pie chart. 99.9% of the world doing an exact match where the VLOOKUP ends in false. It does not matter which way your table is sorted. It could be completely random and you're going to get the answer. This only applies to the 1% of the people doing the approximate match, the comma true version, and for that tiny minority of the people, that is the one place where the table must be sorted. I keep hearing people telling me that the VLOOKUP table has to be sorted, and that's not true 99% of the time. Here's my graphic. So VLOOKUP false, sorting does not matter, right? This is what everyone is running into. But we'll have to increase the zoom. When you're doing VLOOKUP true, if your table is not sorted, you're most likely not going to get the right results. Okay, so Rahim pushes back and Rahim says, well, no, tell me why I'm getting the wrong result. Because you're breaking the rules, Rahim, you're not allowed to do it. But to put this one to bed once and for all, let's talk about what a binary search is. So in every case here, I have 11 values in my lookup table and I am looking up the number 5. All right, so a binary search says, hey, here's our table. We're going to split that table at the midpoint. So with this table that has an odd number of items, the first place that it's going to look is item number 6. And it's going to say, is item number 6 larger or smaller than what I'm looking for? So right here in this table, the VLOOKUP comma true, it's looking for a 5. It comes cruising in here. First place it looks is the 11. And 11 is larger than 5. So then it sends the search routine up into the top half of the table. Now in the top half of the table, we have 5 items, so it's going to look at the midpoint of the 5 items, which is the 5th item, and we get a C. All right, this cell, this 6th cell, the midpoint cell, is oh so critical in determining what answer we're going to get. All right, so here I'm playing with the table. Let's come over here to columns J and K. Exact same VLOOKUP formula, looking up number 5. Exact same table with 11 points. It comes cruising into the middle of the table. It sees minus 3. It says, oh, hey, that's smaller than what I'm looking for. So therefore, I have to go look at the bottom half of the table. Looks at the bottom half of the table. Here's the midpoint. It sees the 7. It says, oh, I have to go up from there. And then we get the 5 and the H. All right. So based on whatever value is in that midpoint cell, that controls which half of the table the binary search is going to go look into. All right, now here's another one. So we're using minus 3 again. That sends it down into the bottom part of the table. Once we're in the bottom part of the table, there's 5 values to look through. It's going to look at the midpoint again. And so here I'm manipulating the results, right? I put a minus 2 here, and that tells Excel, oh, hey, look, in this bottom half of the table, now we're at minus 2, so I must have to go down from here. And I don't know whether it looks at 3 or 5 first, I'm not sure, but it finds the 5 and we get the K. But if I would again manipulate the table, so here's the minus 3 to send me into the lower half, here's the midpoint, here's the 7, which tells Excel that it has to be above this, then it has to choose between the minus 2 and the 3, and we get the result from the 3, because that's, you know, that's the where people say that the true version is the approximate match. It's returning the value just lower, but it's not really doing that at all. It's hopping in here at the middle and then going into the midpoint of that, and then it's trying to find the middle. So even though 5 is in the table twice, because I've manipulated these midpoints that it looks at, I've sent it into a part of the table where it's not going to find the result. And again, I hate discussing this. You're breaking the rules. Don't do a VLOOKUP comma true unless the table is sorted. It's not going to give you the right answers. All right, now, so here I had 11 rows. What happens when we have 10 rows, an even amount? Same kind of thing down here. It becomes the fifth cell. It could be the fifth cell, it could be the sixth cell, but it turns out it's the fifth cell that sends it either down to the bottom half of the table or up into the top half of the table. So whether we get the C or the H depends on that fifth cell. So when we're looking for the midpoint, if it's an odd number, it is the number right in the middle. If it's an even number, it's the the number one above the fictional middle that doesn't exist, like cell or row 20 and a half. There is no row 20 and a half, so it's going to go to the one above that. So I hope that explains it. I feel like this is a wasted podcast because 99% of the world is using the comma false. The other 1%, if they follow the rules, this is not an issue at all. It's just for the people who are on that weird edge case that they're using the true and they refuse to sort their table and they need to understand what's going on. It's it's a crapshoot whether you're going to get the right answer. If you do happen to get the right answer, you just happen to luck out. If your table is not sorted, you're just playing with fire. Don't do it. Wow, I sound like such a angry person here. I'm sorry. I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you on Monday for hopefully a more upbeat headcast. Mr. Excel. MrExcel.com.